Welcome back to Limbo, and when I left you last, we were about to do this whole thing, and I kept on messing it up, so let's actually fix that. I have also adjusted the sound. As I pointed out in the comments last week, I was trying to do a little experiment where, because Limbo is a particularly moody game, I wanted you to be able to hear more of the noise, but then it turned out that the noise was too noisy, and you couldn't hear me, which is not a problem, it just didn't work very well. So I have subsequently fixed that. Alright, we need to move. This has to happen fairly quickly. Run, little dude. There we go. Right. Now we're going to swing a bit to make this a little easier. And hop. When they're both about even, like, now, we're gonna run. Run! Much better than last week. I practiced PS, so this shouldn't be nearly as terrible as it was last week. There are a couple of puzzles I may not remember. This is important. You see the frog eating there? Hang on. Let's go away. Okay, we're not gonna get to attract him again, but there was a frog and he was eating at that luminescent stuff, and that's going to be fairly important in a second. And this is scary as all get out. So there's like a thing attached to your brain. What is this even about? Let's see. I think I remember this. And we're going to go, and jump. Yeah, I remember. And don't push the box. I learned that the very hard way. So, this little thing, I guess it's a brain sucker, I suppose, I'm not sure. It will attach to you and it will make you walk in whichever direction that it wants you to go. You don't have control. You can jump and you can move faster in the direction that you're going, but that's about all you can do. And again, like I said, I'm sure that that sort of thing... There we go, he's trying to get at that food. Oh, that's so sad. What I'm about to do is really mean. I'm sure that kind of thing has, you know, meaning to the story. Anyway, so... Oh, I didn't do it right. Okay. Things like the brain sucker guys, they probably have meaning with regards to the story. There we go. Come on, little buddy. I gotta do it faster than that. There we go. Now I'm gonna chase him. This is kind of sad. What am I about to do, poor guy? Oh god, I'm sorry. I feel terrible about this. So he gets to running. And we're gonna make it rain through his running. There we go. As I say, Limbo is very much about the experience, and so what I was trying to do when I had the volume up loud like that was, I was trying to give you the exact experience of what it's like to be playing this game. Because it is very kind of moody and dour, maybe even more so than Police Quest, for those of you who watch me play that. Oh, goodness. One of the things that there is speculation about is, for me anyway, when you see your protagonist, he doesn't look like he's particularly old. And the guess is, you know, maybe he's someone's son or the like. And so the reason why... The thing about Limbo is that Limbo is, like I said last week, it's the spot between heaven and hell. And you go there if you have been not terrible enough to end up in hell, but not good enough to end up in heaven. And so there's this problem with that whole situation where the way it turns out is that according to especially Catholic doctrine, there's this, oh goodness, I didn't mean for you to drown, I'm sorry guy. There's this concept of original sin, and the way original sin works is that when Adam and Eve were in the Garden of Eden, they partook of the fruits from the tree, because they got tricked into doing that by the snake. So the idea was that in Catholicism, adults, oh, and I keep on doing that, adults have some idea of what they're doing, so for them it's a choice to be bad or to be good. But then the other problem is, like, what if you're an infant? What if you're small and you're not rational enough to make decisions? Now, the doctrine of original sin suggests that basically fundamentally everyone is born into sin as a result of Adam and Eve. And because everyone is born into sin, they can't make the choice about, especially in Catholic doctrine, whether or not to accept, you know, Jesus and God and all that in their lives. When they don't, when people can't make that rational choice, like a baby can't make that rational choice, the question then becomes, you know, where do they end up? And there's a slightly different version of Limbo for those people. I wouldn't say it's a different version of Limbo, it's just a slightly nicer version of Limbo. And they call that, like, that the Limbo of Infants. I'm probably going to screw this up too, because all of this afternoon when I was practicing this, I was doing this terribly. I think I'm okay. I must just remember to jump at the right spot. And so, like I say, his age, relatively speaking, makes me wonder if this isn't necessarily the limbo of infants, but it may not be like an adult version of limbo entirely, because we haven't seen any adults really. So there's, you know, all sorts of story speculation about that. Right, let's get the show on the road. I don't mind this puzzle too much, because this is just, you know, once you figure it out, it's timing. There we go. There's a couple of puzzles in this section that I really like. This is one of them. I mean, it's not friendly, because you're about to drown. But the meter sort of thing of the puzzle is pretty cool. You know, the way you do what you're doing. Oh, this is a really frustrating puzzle if you don't know what's going on. So, watch carefully now. I'm going to drain this. And as you can see, all the water's coming out the left. Now, if I go up here, and I jump at the right time, because that's always a problem with this puzzle, you'll notice that when I pull this down, the water does come up, but it comes up and it's spurting out the left-hand side, so we need to change that very quickly. Now let's close this guy. And I think now that when I... Oh, careful. You don't want to die. I think I have it right now. I'm not really... Oh, hold on. Let's get that back up in there. And jump. Because the thing I remember is you have to get it so that the water comes out from the right. There we go. That's exactly correct. Okay, ooh. Wait, hold on. We want that to close. So now we have enough water in both sides that we can displace the water properly. And in theory, we should be alright. seems correct. Oop, I hate that last jump. It's always pretty scary. There's a lot of little things like that, you know, how old is the protagonist? Other questions that arise under this are, like, where are we exactly? Is this part of his subconscious? Are these all things that he saw in his subconscious, or he experienced at some point, and to different degrees? Why is that brain sucker thing? I mean, what's up with that? I have ideas about all those sorts of things, but they're not entirely worth speculating on until we see the end. Okay, let's see if I remember how. Well, not how to do this, but if I can do it fast enough. Whoa. And we're gonna jump. Man, okay, so now I better move. Because it's probably not noticeable yet, but the water level's rising. And I've got to get up. And, because he's currently going to the left, if I leave him alone, he's going to walk to the left. I need him, he need him to be going to the right. Oh boy. This is probably the most stressful part of this game. Oh goodness. Is when a brain sucker attaches itself to you. Now we wait. I'm gonna hold on to see if the water level's rising. And of course it is. But in theory we should be okay. I must just remember to jump at the very last moment. Like I wasn't doing all afternoon when I was practicing. Oh, Limbo, I love you. You're such a good game, but you're so, so, so picky. Okay, I think this should be good. There we go. And jump. Where am I going? Am I going upwards? I think I am. I believe so. Yeah, I am. Oh. I don't think I got here on my tests. Did I? No, I did not, in fact. And I'm probably not going to remember how to do this. Yeah, there we go. You gotta be careful here, because that could fall. Man. Do I ever not? Oh yes, I didn't get here on my tests. So this guy here, this is out and out platforming. You can run along the bottom here for a little bit, but then you kinda can't. I mean, big gap there, and there's no way you can make that jump. So literally what you have to do is you have to go across. Now this is one of the things I mean, is, like, what is this hotel thing all about? Because that's what it says. That's not a spoiler, by the way, because it's on the back of the box. Oh, goodness. Jumping at the wrong time. Here we go. Let's go. There. I was hoping I made that on time, but I didn't. There's going to be a lot of deaths from now on because I don't remember what to do. Because this is the bit I never practiced. Oh, nope. Okay. Oh, no, that's too late. And now we will jump. Ah, that wasn't in time. It is totally possible to make that jump, I'm just being dumb. Up, and... Oh, almost. Now. See, I shouldn't be quite... There we go. That's a whole lot better. Okay, now, if I remember this correctly... Now I can get across there, and I have to do this fairly quickly because that rope's gonna stop swinging at some point. There we go. Alright. Good news. I can turn everything off. But I have to again, because that rope is going to stop swinging. There we go. Oh boy. This is one of the sections that I always dreaded in every playthrough. Exactly because it was like precise timing with that particular age jump there. So, as you're seeing the sign here that says hotel, again, you know, the question arises, why is that there? What actually happened? Oh, I didn't do that in time. Oh, goodness. Ow, I'm sorry, guy. What actually happened at a hotel or at the top of a hotel? Because normally they have this sort of sign at the top of a hotel. That we're seeing this in his version of Limbo. I like that kind of thing. I like the speculation of it. Where you see things, but they're not exactly spelt out to you. Well, this kind of is, because it's got the word hotel. Did you see what I did there? Oh goodness, that was terrible. Okay. I think I remember this. Yes, I do. I do indeed. I don't know how many, where I need to jump here. There we go. Okay. And then we're going to pick up this card. This card is going to be a thing we're going to see again. Not exactly like this, but we will see it again. Okay, so what we need to do is, that needs to have a lot of momentum. Yeah, more momentum than it's having right now. And I don't know if this is enough momentum though. Nope. Not nearly. Hold on. And again, you know, what is going on with this cart? Why are we seeing it here? There we go. That was nearly the right idea. It looks like the sort of thing that, you know, a kid of his age might have constructed. Yeah. Let's do that. Just to play around with. There we go. Oh, goodness. I think I'm going to die. Yeah. I knew it. You know, where you and your brothers and sisters or whoever might have constructed a thing sort of like this to play on. What's going on with that? That sort of thing. Okay, let's not die. I think I need to go to the left. Jump. Oh, yes, but not quite like that. Try it one more time. And if I don't manage it then we'll call an episode because we're about at time. Up. And jump. Whoa, not like that. As you can see, we're headed for disaster again because we're going to get a brain sucker guy coming up soon. One last attempt. That's kind of what this game is like. You get into playing it and as long as it's not being frustrating, it's, you know, one last attempt and we'll see how we can go. There we are. Jump. Let's get as close as we can. Yeah, that's better. Where is this going to take us? Downward. Oh, there we go. And that's where we'll end. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, lostwolfe. This has been episode 3 of Limbo. I hope you're enjoying the kind of... I wouldn't say enjoying, but I hope you're appreciating the distinction between this and The Dig if you're watching that. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you soon. Have a great week, folks. And goodbye.